This is Apollo Control at 12 hours, 5 minutes. We expect to have the unscheduled television transmission which came in to Goldstone, California, and was taped there and has been transmitted to Mission Control Center, ready and converted for replay in color at 8:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. That would be about 7 minutes from now. The TV transmission runs for a total time of about 16 and a half minutes and is of an exterior shot out the window of the Earth. At the time of the transmission, Apollo 11 was some 50,980 nautical miles from Earth. The transmission came into Goldstone at a ground elapsed time of 10:32:40 and ended about 16 and a half minutes later when the spacecraft was at an altitude of 52,248 nautical miles. We'll stand by for a replay of that transmission at 8:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This is Apollo Control at 12 hours, 12 minutes. We expect to be ready to release the television transmission from the spacecraft, which was received at Goldstone, California. That should be ready to go in a little less than a minute. We are starting to get lock-on from the tape replay, and we expect that we will have a color picture shortly.
Receiving at TV, stand by, we'll let you know on the quality, over.
Okay, my comments were
My comments were from Goldstone that they see no white spots as we saw in 10. Looks like the AGC is working real well. The F-22 looks good, over.
Okay, very good. Well, we shut out the sun coming in some of the other ones under the spacecraft, so it's looking through a number one window, and there isn't any reflected light right now, so it ought to be a pretty good picture.
Roger. Houston, we'd like you to keep the TV on for about 10 minutes or so, so we can get some good comparison on the camera. You can do anything here.
Hey Houston, you suppose you could turn the earth a little bit so we could get a little bit more than just water?
Roger, 11. I don't think we got much control over that. Looks like you'll have to settle for the water. Taking our voice uplink to another site. If you'll stand by, we'll see if we can improve the quality, over.
Okay, John. We'll stand by for your call.
TV request. We'd like 10 minutes worth of TV, and we'd like a narrative, if you could give us one on the exterior shots. You could. We also suggest you might try the an interior position, over.
Roger, we're seeing the center of the Earth as viewed from the spacecraft in the eastern Pacific Ocean. We have not been able to visually pick up the Hawaiian island chain, but we can clearly see the western coast of North America, the United States, the San Joaquin Valley, the High Sierras, Baja California, and Mexico down as far as Acapulco and the Yucatan Peninsula, and you can see on through Central America to the northern coast of South America, Venezuela and Colombia. I'm not sure you'll be able to see all that on your screens down there.
Roger, Neil, we just wanted a narrative such that we can, when we get to playback, we can sort of correlate what we're seeing. Thank you very much.
I haven't seen anything but the disky so far.
Looks like they're hogging the windows.
You're right.
This is Apollo Control. The view that we have of the Earth disk at this time, as near as we can tell, the North Pole is to the left of the screen. The land mass that was visible was the western coast of the United States. The Earth then would appear to be rotated 90 degrees with the North Pole to the left, and South America and the South American continent extending toward the upper right of the globe, but not visible. That concludes the unscheduled television transmission. That transmission came in about 2 hours ago at a ground elapsed time of 10:32:40 beginning. Lasted about 16 and a half minutes. At the beginning of the transmission, Apollo 11 was about 50,980 nautical miles from Earth, and at the conclusion, about 52,248 nautical miles. At the present time, the crew is in a scheduled rest period. They did indicate before going into the rest period, when we last heard from them, that they would probably use part of the time to get a bite to eat and then get some sleep. At this time, Apollo 11 is 59,908 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 7,569 feet per second. At 12 hours, 31 minutes, this is Mission Control, Houston. This is Apollo Control at 12 hours, 47 minutes. We've just put in a call to the crew. Flight Director Gene Kranz verified with the surgeon that they had not gone to sleep at this point. And capsule communicator Charlie Duke has put in the call. We'll pick up the tape of the conversation and then stand by for any following live communication with the crew.
Apollo 11, Houston. Hope you aren't, we aren't disturbing you. We'd like you to terminate the noun 65 now, over.
All right.
Apollo 11, Houston, over.
Houston, Apollo
11, roger. But when you, when you terminated the noun 65, it appeared to us you did a verb 46, which collapsed the dead band back to 0.5. We're okay as long as you do not turn on any auto RCF select switches, over.
Okay. That's clear way to clear the 50, but that's definitely enough.
Roger. Roger. Verb 34 would have been a better procedure.
Yeah.
This is Apollo Control. We don't anticipate a great deal of further conversation with the crew. We expect they will attempt to get some sleep shortly. The conversation that just ended, we advised that through one of the computer programs, the dead band, or that area of excursions which the guidance system will allow before firing the RCS thrusters to correct it, had been narrowed from 30 degrees to 0.5 degree. What this would mean if the RCS jets were enabled is that unless the crew reselected the 30 degree dead band, the jets would be firing more frequently to keep the spacecraft within the narrower limits. Since the spacecraft is very stable at this point, very few wobbling motions, it was felt that the narrower dead band was acceptable. The jets are not enabled, and the crew would not be disturbed by firing of the reaction control system jets, even if the spacecraft moved out of the 0.5 degree dead band. In the event of any large excursions, which we would not expect based on the passive thermal control mode used in Apollo 10, it would be possible to awaken the crew from the ground and have the situation corrected. We would not expect, however, for the spacecraft attitude to change significantly during the night, and we do intend to continue in the passive thermal control mode as it is presently set up. At this time, Apollo 11 is 61,509 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 7,449 feet per second, which would translate to about 5,000 miles an hour. At 12 hours 54 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 13 hours, 27 minutes into the flight of Apollo 11. The spacecraft now traveling at a speed of 7,279 feet per second, which would be about 4,963 miles an hour. And it's at a distance of 63,880 nautical miles from Earth. Our flight surgeon reported a short while ago that command module pilot Mike Collins appeared to be sleeping soundly at this time. Biomedical data on the other two crewmen indicates that they are still awake. We've had no further conversation with the spacecraft since our last report. And it appears that the crew will be getting some good rest either as scheduled or perhaps a little earlier than scheduled in the flight plan. At 13 hours, 28 minutes, this is Mission Control, Houston.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control. At 14 hours, 6 minutes into the flight of Apollo 11, the mission is progressing very smoothly. All spacecraft systems are functioning normally at this time, and the flight surgeon reports that all three crewmen appear to be sleeping. For Commander Neil Armstrong and Lunar Module Pilot Buzz Aldrin, they appeared to begin sleeping about 5 minutes ago. Command Module Pilot Mike Collins has been asleep for about an additional 30 minutes to an hour. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 66,554 nautical miles from Earth and traveling at a speed of about 7,095 feet per second, which would be about 4,800 miles an hour. We've had no further conversation with the crew since our last report, and as I said, all three crewmen appear to be sleeping at this time. At 14 hours, 7 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control, 14 hours, 25 minutes into the flight of Apollo 11. The spacecraft presently 67,819 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 7,012 feet per second. Here in Mission Control, the shift change is in progress. Flight Director Glenn Lunny and his team of flight controllers coming on to replace Gene Kranz and his white team. The capsule communicator on the upcoming shift will be Ron Evans. And we anticipate that the change of shift briefing for this shift will begin in about 10 or 15 minutes. At 14 hours, 26 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.